programa. Welcome all. Good morning to you. We are going to get started here right now. We thank you for all those that are tuned in on Facebook Live and on the Trinity Baptist prayer line this morning. We just want to welcome you in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. I pray that you have a pen and paper ready as God speaks to us today, where we can take notes and learn from his message he has for us today. This morning, my son will open us up with the scripture, and as he comes, prepare yourselves for the word of the Lord.
Today we'll be reading from Matthew chapter 6, verses 1 through 6. Take heed that ye do not your alms before men to see of them, otherwise ye have no reward of your Father which is in heaven. Therefore, when thou doest thine alms, do not sound a trumpet before thee, as thou hypocrites do in the synagogues and in the streets, that they may have glory of men. Verily, I say unto you, they have their reward. But when thou doest alms, let not thy left hand know what thy right hand doeth. Let thy alms may be in secret, and thy Father which seeth in secret himself shall reward thee openly. And when thou prayest, thou shalt not be as the hypocrites are, for they love to pray standing in the synagogues and in the corner of the streets, that they may be seen of men. Verily, I say unto you, they have their reward. But thou, when thou prayest, enter into thy closet, and when thou hast shut thy door, pray to thy Father which is in secret, and thy Father which seeth in secret shall reward thee openly.
Thank you, son. Praise the Lord for that reading. Today we're going to be talking about you might be a churchin instead of a Christian. Now you're saying, hey, what in the world is a churchin? Well, that's what we're going to talk about today. What is a churchin? We're going to talk about the differences between being a Christian and being a churchin. Now, what is a churchin? It's all in the name. If you think about it, the word church and then I-A-N, and then you think about Christian, you have I-A-N. So what is a churchin? A churchin is someone that follows a church or a pastor or the world. That's what a churchin is. But what is a Christian? A Christian is just that. Someone that follows Christ, a born again believer where the new birth has taken place. So there's the difference. We have a churchin, one that's following the world, one that's following a church or following a pastor, or a Christian that's following Christ. Now, what does the Bible say about a Christian? Acts chapter 11, verse 26 is the very first time where we see the word Christian is used in the Bible. And I'm telling you, this is an important part. I want you to really pay attention here. Acts chapter 11, verse 26. And it reads this way. And when he had found him, oh, I love that. He brought him unto Antioch. And it came to pass that a whole year, listen to this, they assembled themselves with the church and taught much people, and the disciples were called Christians first at Antioch. Woo, my Lord, I tell you, that is good. I've done some study there. Antioch is so important because that's where we receive the word of God at, and this is the first place where we're seeing the disciples who are following Christ being called Christians. Now, one thing I want you to see here, it says they assembled with the church. They didn't assemble in the church. They assembled with the church. I hope you see the big difference there. We have it so wrong when we say we are going to church. You can never, ever go to church. I hope you hear me well. The church is made up of a body of believers. We are the church. We never go to the church. I wish we stopped saying we're going to church. And that is the problem. If we're going to church, That's the problem. The church needs to be in you. But as we see here in the book of Acts, they assembled themselves with the church, and look what they did. They taught much people. Are you being taught in the church? If not, that could be the problem. So the difference is a churchin is one that's all about church. You can talk to these people, and all they talk about is their church and their pastor. You never, ever hear them talking about Christ. I go look at some people's Facebook feeds, and I'm telling you, I'm like, who are they worshiping here? The church, the pastor, or Christ? And sad to say, they are following man and following a church. Now, I'm going to give you three things here that's going to help you to determine whether you are a churchin' or whether you are a Christian. Three things. That's all, and we'll be out of here. The first thing is Jesus said, my sheep hear my voice, and they follow me. So you ask yourself the question, are you hearing God's voice, and are you following Jesus? That will tell you if you are a Christian. I like the way the Bible puts it in John chapter 10, verse 4 through 5. John chapter 10, verse 4 through 5. Listen to what the Bible says. And he put forth his own sheep. He goeth before them, and the sheep follow him, and they know his voice. Goodness gracious alive. His sheep know his voice and follow him. Have you ever been in a situation when you hear the voice of God and you're simply following it? But then when you hear the voice of the wicked one, you say, no, that ain't of God. I have no part of that. I've been there. Even in churches where they're doing things that are not right, I will not participate if it's not from God. So we got to make sure that we are hearing God's word and following him. But the key thing I want you to see here is that the sheep know his voice. I guarantee you, the sheep has been in God's word and studying. And when God's word is inside of you, it will come out. Now, verse 5 says, and a stranger they will not follow, but will flee from him, for they know not the voice of strangers. Wow. Who are we listening to? I'm telling you, so many times today, we have Christians listening to so much junk. They're listening to secular music, and they say, oh, I can handle it. Oh, I can still do it. Then they're listening to the world with all the things that they're saying that we should be doing. We should be just like these sheep that will not follow the voice of a stranger. The Bible say they flee from him. Are we fleeing from sin, or we're comfortable in it? That's the question. That's going to tell you right there. If you are comfortable in doing the things that you know God told you not to do, wow, you may be a churchin instead of a Christian. So the question is, whose voice are you hearing and who are you following? It's just that simple. Now, the next thing here is, are we hearing God's word? James chapter 1, verse 22 to 27. I love this. Wow, we can spend some time here, but I'm going to try to speed it up here. James chapter 1, verse 22 to 27. And let's just look at what God's word says. It says, but be ye doers of the word, and not hearers only, deceiving your own selves. How many times we hear God's word and we don't do it? I want you to understand, the Bible tells us the devil believe and tremble. They don't do God's word. But a churchin will go to church 24/7. Every time the door is open, they'll be in church. But when it comes down to doing it, they will not do the word of God. They're simply deceiving themselves. They're going to church because of tradition. It makes them feel good. They feel morally obligated. But when it comes down to do what God tells them to do, they will not do it. Now let's keep reading verse 23. For if any be a hearer of the word and not a doer, he is like unto a man beholding his face in a glass. For he beholdeth himself and goeth his way, and straightway forgetteth what manner of man he was. But whoso looketh into the perfect law of liberty and continueth therein, he being not a forgetful hearer, but a doer of the work, this man shall be blessed in his deeds. There you have it. They are doing the work of God. You know, the Bible tells us faith without works is dead. I will show you my faith by my works. But as the scripture says, if you have no works, your faith is dead. We see so many people sitting in a pew that never do what Christ tells them to do. They're always talking about it, but they're never doing it. Well, the scripture is very clear. If you're not doing it, the change hasn't taken place. And this is what we have been preaching here these last few series. I didn't plan this, trust me. But there's a separation going on here. As we talked about a couple of weeks ago, the sheep versus the goat. We talked about the 10 virgins, 5 wives, 5 unwives. There is a division taking place, and God is saying, hey, whose side are you on? And as we're talking here, if we're only hearing God's word and not doing it, there's a problem. So many times Christians talk a good game, but they never do any action. Now, what does the Bible say a true religion is? As we're reading here in James here, let's read the last 2 verses here, 26 and 27. I want you to pay attention here because this will tell it like it is here. It says, if any man among you seem to be religious, there we go right there. You know, they put up a good front, and bridleth not his tongue, but deceiveth his own heart, this man's religion is in vain. You ever talk to some people with no filter? They'll just say anything out of their mouth. They don't know how to bridle that mouth. The Lord put that tongue behind 2 sets of teeth and 2 lips to keep it shut. But this person doesn't bridle their tongue. They'll just say anything to hurt somebody. They'll say anything and cuss them out. But man, God says pure religion is that we learn to bridle our tongue. Because if not, I hear the saying, that's just the way I am. Well, that's a problem. You need to be born again. If you're still under assumption, that's just the way you are, and you're not going to change, you are just a hearer of God's word and not a doer. Don't fool yourself. Now, verse 27, here we go. We're getting there. It says, pure religion and undefiled before God and the Father is this: to visit the fatherless and widows in their affliction, and to keep himself unspotted from the world. Wow. That is what pure religion is. It is action. It is love in action. It says to visit the fathers and widows. Look, where are you going to visit them at? Where? In their affliction. We don't want you to just visit me when things are going well. God says, hey, you are my hands, you're my feet. I want you to visit them in their affliction. Wow. That means you're not just hearing God's word, you're being a doer. When you see a brother or sister, or for that matter, anybody in need, and you have the means to help, and you don't do it, how dwelleth the love of God in you? I can tell you it doesn't, because you're selfish. It's all about you. You will not make the sacrifice to help anyone. You are simply a hearer of God's word and not a doer. Now, as we're coming around the corner here, I wanted to get to this one. The first one is, you hear God's word and are you following him? You know it. Then it says, are you hearers and not doers? You know it. But here's the next one. Love tells it all. Are you able to love? Are you able to love your brethren? I hope you take these two verses down. It will help you. 1 John chapter 3, verse 15. 1 John chapter 3, verse 15. It says, whoso hateth his brother is a murderer. And ye know that no murderer hath eternal life abiding in him. Goodness gracious alive. You go around saying, hey, I love the Lord, I'm a Christian, but you're hating your brother. And the Bible simply says, no murderer hath eternal life. You didn't even fire a shot or stab anybody, but you done killed someone because you're hating them. You are a murderer. In the Bible, you know, even one of the Ten Commandments, thou shalt not kill. And you have no eternal life abiding in him if you're hating your brother. Now, the next verse even gets even better. You can't miss it here. 1 John chapter 4, verse 20. And it really gets you right here. 1 John chapter 4, verse 20. If a man say, I love God, there we go, and hateth his brother, he is a liar. For he that loveth not his brother whom he hath seen, how can he love God whom he hath not seen? Wow. There you have it right there. It is so clear. If you are hating your brother and saying that you love God, you are lying. Stop lying. Stop fooling yourself. Just like we talked earlier, stop deceiving yourself. You know what you're doing. You are not following Christ, but yet you're still in your sins, and the Lord is not pleased. Now, when the time comes to forgive and you don't do it, this tells you exactly where you are. You know, churchians go to church all their lives learning about Christ, even preaching and teaching. But when the time comes for them to forgive, they can't do it. You know, I see it so many times. You know, when we're in a body of Christ and we assemble together in a building and we're assembling all the time, we're going to not be on the same page all the time. We're going to hurt somebody. Our feelings are going to get hurt, but not for us to not forgive. The Bible says we should forgive 70 times 7. Well, if you're counting, if you never forgive the first time. That was the thing that he was trying to explain to you. If you haven't forgiven, the number doesn't matter. He wants you to forgive and move on. I've been hurt. Yes, I've been hurt. But I love this person. I love my brother. I don't hate him. But I've seen where Christians get upset, storm out, and never come back to church again. How dwelleth the love of God in you? You've taught and preached to many people, but now it's your time to forgive, and you can't do it. Been going to church all their lives. They're churchians. They haven't submitted themselves to God. Now, Matthew chapter 6, we all know this one. Matthew chapter 6, verse 14 to 15. It says, if ye forgive men their trespasses, your heavenly Father will also forgive you. Well, thank you, Lord. But if ye forgive not men in their trespasses, neither will your Father forgive your trespasses. That means you're not saved. I want to be clear here. He's saying in 14, if you forgive, you have been forgiven. Therefore, Christ is in you. But he's saying in verse 15, if you do not forgive your brethren, he will not forgive you. And if you haven't been forgiven of sins, you are in your sin, and a wrath of God abideth on you. I hope this is helping somebody. It's so simple. Forgiveness, love will tell it all. Are you able to love? Now, as we wrap it up here, there's some things that we need to consider here. You might be a churchin if you do these three things right here. I want you to pay attention. You might be a churchin if you spread gossip instead of spreading the gospel. And you know, are you talking more about people than you're talking about Christ? Are you sharing juicy news with what's going on? Or are you sharing good news about what is going on and what's about to come? You might be a churchin if you're just simply gossiping. The next thing, you might be a churchin if you are following a pastor, a church, instead of following Christ. I've seen sometimes when a pastor leaves a church, half of the congregation leaves. Wow! I'm asking you one question. Who are you following? I don't know about you, but the Lord is my shepherd. I shall not want. We need to follow Christ instead of following a man or a church or a denomination. We need to make sure that we are following Christ. Are you a churchin or are you a Christian? And here we go. You know, this is my favorite one. You might be a churchin if you talk about fishing for souls instead of being a fisher of men. I like to read Matthew chapter 4, verse 19. Matthew chapter 4, verse 19. And he said unto them, follow me, and I will make you fishers of men. So it's really simple. You can look at your activities to find out whether you're following Christ. And if you're following Christ, you are a Christian. Or are you following the world? You are churchin. This is really determined is if your heart is for soul winning and if you're doing it. There are so many ways that you can reach out to witness. You don't have to be in the best health. You don't have to know all the scriptures. He is simply saying, be a witness. I want to give you a challenge that I was given yesterday. I want you to find five people that you are connected to, and you know either one, they're backslidden, or they don't know Christ. And I want you to contact them this week. I'm doing the same thing. If you can't do that, this is going to determine whether you're fishing for men. Are you following Christ? I want you to choose five people that you know that need to hear a word from the Lord and contact them. Will you do it? It will determine whether you are a churchin, you talk about fishing for souls, or are you fishing for men and actually doing something. The proof of the pudding is in the eating. Are you doing what has taken place in your heart? This is the whole purpose of this lesson today. And as I'm closing here, I want you to examine your fruits and see where you are. The fruits will tell where you're at. Whenever you see something coming from a tree, that's how you tell what type of tree is it. If that tree has oranges, it's an orange tree. If it has apples, it's an apple tree. So if your fruits are producing things that are against what God says, do not fool yourself. You are a churchin and not a Christian. You are following the world. Now, let me tell you where this is at in the Bible. I'm not going to read this, but I want you to just go, you know, study this your own. Galatians chapter 5, verse 19 to 25. Galatians chapter 5, verse 19 and 25. It lists the fruit. It lists the works of the flesh, and then it lists the fruit of the Spirit. And as you go through that list, if you're doing those things under the flesh, you need to do some business with the Lord. If you find out that you may be a churchin instead of a Christian, you need to get right before the Lord. Now, how do you get right before the Lord? One, you have to recognize you are a sinner. The first step to any cure is recognizing that you're sick. Recognize that you are a churchin. Recognize that you are following the flesh. Recognize that you're following the world and you're not following Christ. And then what you need to do is then go before the Lord and say, Father, I'm a sinner and I'm sorry for my sins. And then you need to ask Jesus Christ to come into your heart and he'll do it. So right now, I'll give you the opportunity. If this message has spoke to you, that you are a churchin instead of a Christian. In other words, you're following the world and not following Christ. You're following the flesh and not living in the Spirit. Here's what you can do to become a Christian. You simply, one, you need to say this prayer and believe it in your heart. Remember, the prayer doesn't save you if you don't believe it. You have to believe. Faith comes by hearing, and hearing by the word of God. So if you want to become a Christian and want to be 100% sure, say this prayer. Say, Dear God, I come now confessing I am a sinner and I'm sorry for my sins. I believe that Jesus died, was buried, and on the third day rose from the grave. I accept him now into my heart. Thank you, Jesus, for saving me. So if you've prayed that prayer, I ask that you go to our website, minutesoftruth.org, click on the contact form and drop us a line. We'd like to send you some information. But thank you for joining. Are you a churchin or a Christian?